Human-wildlife conflicts have been on the rise here in southern Africa for decades. In Mozambique, the human population has grown to over 30 million, with nearly half having no plumbing and relying on river access, the same rivers African wildlife rely on. Deaths from these conflicts, both human and wildlife, have risen over 300% in only a few years. And if we don't act, it's going to get much worse.
Mitch, get out! Get out! Mitchell! Look, there's an elephant! There's an elephant right there.
Big bull elephant. Look at that.
I got it on film.
Where'd he go?
It just ran this way.
All right, let's go see if anybody got hurt.
Thankfully, there don't seem to be any injuries.
What am I to do? This is all God. I have to do the wrong.
I know, we can't kill the elephant. What happened?
Yeah, elephant.
It's the same elephant that's coming around here.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, I'm very sorry, Baba. I'm very, very sorry. We're gonna try and solve this problem. It's not a bad elephant, it's a bad situation. Yeah, and that's the problem here.
Until I get a look at the animal, I can't even begin to figure out why it's harming this village. It could be hurt or poisoned by poachers, so we'll check for visible wounds. It could be acting erratically out of desperation, competing for resources like food and water with this farming village. What we do know is that although it's rare, an elephant can be incredibly destructive. A full-size male like this one can reach 13 feet at the shoulder and weigh up to 20,000 pounds. An adult bull can use their trunks to hurl large objects at you, crush you underfoot, or gore you with their massive tusks.
Oh, wow, look up here, guys. Look at this. Something big has died right here. And on first investigation, I would actually think this is elephant, because this is elephant poo. See the light brown color? Look at the size of this rib bone. First thought, big animal, that's from an elephant. That's an elephant's rib. But when you compare it to the length of the femur, that femur is nowhere near long enough to be from an elephant. So this is definitely from a hippo. Here's his tooth. But what's interesting is there's no skull around here, and there's signs of elephant. So there's a whole lot going on that we can pick up from reading this situation. The hippopotamus has come in. He's died right here. And in has come an elephant to investigate. Now, you don't see all the remnants of the hippopotamus. Why is that? Okay, elephants do this very interesting thing where they're fascinated by bones, and they'll actually pick bones up and move them and scatter them around. It's a comment on their intelligence. They don't want things to come and find remains, so they spread out the bones. So if you keep looking, it's fascinating. Like, look at all the pieces of the puzzle. Look at this. There's the lower jaw. Come and get this here. If we don't get the elephants out of here, they're gonna end up just like this. Eyes out, guys. I'm not seeing any tracks yet. So it opens up over here. Stop right there. Look at this. See this? Perfect elephant track. So you can see here, the bottom of an elephant's pad is just like the human finger. Every single ridge is unique. And you can see that these are very, very fresh. What I can do is take a photograph.
This will allow me to compare prints from the village to confirm this is the same elephant.
The other thing that's so fascinating about pachyderms, about elephants, we've recently discovered that the sensitivity that they have in the pads of their feet, they can pick up vibrations through the ground.
they're likely to actually feel us coming through the ground before they hear us, and it just makes us that much less likely to catch up to an elephant that doesn't want to be caught. So, just gonna have to keep going quietly. Oh, look here, look. Shh, shh, shh. This is fresh, guys. Look, we're on the right trail. You see how fresh this is? Feel that temperature. Feel it. It's warm. All right. So we're very close now. So here's what we're gonna do, Mitch. I want you to grab a big chunk of this. You're not gonna like this. John, you too, I'm afraid. And here's what we're gonna do, guys. Watch me. You're gonna mask your scent, okay? They have great sense of smell. And the truth is, they know exactly what we're doing, so. Yep. Put it all over it. Now, if we're up or downwind, at least we smell like a bit of elephant instead of people. We're very close now, guys. This has been worth this hike. Quietly, single file, okay? Let's go. Stop. Back up. Look at that. That is a massive bull elephant.
He's calm, not under any obvious distress. That likely rules out any poisons from poachers. But from this distance, I can't tell if he's injured. And he clearly knows we're watching.
Yeah, he's really just not letting us get close at all. Yeah, there he goes. We're just chasing him at this point.
Which is a problem if we want to actually learn anything about him. So let's do this. Do you have the thermal drone with you?
Yeah.
Let's get it up. Ready? Yep.
Okay, so go to thermal.
He's smart. He knows exactly how to camouflage himself amongst the trees. The thermal drone makes it much easier to spot him. By picking out his unique heat signature.
Okay, so go that way, Mitch.
I'm fairly confident this is the same elephant from the village attack, but so far he's only shown us his backside. And what's dropped out of it. I got a good look at the tusks on the elephant during this morning's attack. So if I can confirm a match, we'll be certain.
There, right there. That's him?
Yep, that's him.
Right on the edge of the woods.
Yep, how far away is he?
About a mile.
African elephants have been recorded running as fast as 25 miles per hour, like a living freight train.
Look at the size of that bull.
That's a big animal.
Huge. Look at those tusks. Guys, this is a massive bull elephant.
He's unmistakable and rare. You're not going to see another bull this size outside of a national park. He doesn't appear wounded at all. I believe this is an animal that has been forced into human territory purely out of hunger and thirst. Any destruction he's caused was probably out of fear, as he's been shot at and scared off.
You know, we have to save this animal.
Over the last decade, nearly half the population of Mozambique's elephants have been slaughtered by poachers. And with fewer than 10,000 remaining, every life counts.
Can you make a GPS mark of where he is?
Yeah, I can pull up to that.
Oh, hold on. What's that over there?
Holy, look at all the other ones.
Oh my God. That is a problem.
This changes everything. The male is part of a big herd, and while I'm happy to have an answer, the solution is going to be much more challenging.
It's a crazy situation.
We can't stop a herd of elephants going into a village.
This herd of elephants is at least a dozen strong.
There's a mother, there's calves, there's everything.
What are our options? We're a team of five people.
This just got a whole lot harder.